Let's lift our hands in this place. Father, we open this prayer service right now, acknowledging who you are, and we give you glory this morning. We give you honor, and we give you the praise this morning. And we say, Lord, whatever you're going to do this weekend, do it with power, do it prophetically, do it with your presence. And we say this morning that there will be no hindrances, there will be no walls, there will be no chains. We come ahead of time. I feel the anointing on me already. We just been 3 minutes in this. We come ahead of time and we break every chain that has been wrapped around the ankles of every woman that's going to be at this conference. God, women that are boarding planes right now from around the world coming, women that are packing cars, that are getting behind the wheel, devil, we bind you in the name of Jesus, and we loose today freedom, we lose favor, and I want to declare in the name of Jesus that when you walk through the back doors of Judah into Covered Girl, you are not going to leave the same way you came. You're going to come at ground level, and you're going to leave soaring into the altitude above every struggle and adversary, every trial, every trouble, everything that has bound you, everything that has come against you. Right now, before you get here, we loose it in the name of Jesus, and we call for divine power to rest upon Pastor Kendall tonight at 7 o'clock. God, anoint her like you never anointed her before. Put your hand on her. She's been in prayer for 48 hours, consecration for 48 hours. So God, I'm declaring right now a supernatural anointing on Pastor Kendall Brown tonight as she opens our conference. And tomorrow morning, Lord, rest your hand on Pastor Jocelyn Williams. Give her an anointing, a word, and give her insight like she's never had before. Let this be a fresh rhema word, like manna falling from heaven into the lives of our women. And then tomorrow night, Father, we pray for C.C. Winans as she comes, your worshiper in our nation. She is a vessel of worship and praise and power and preaching. Anoint her, Lord. Let her reach back into that generational anointing and pull her mama's anointing and her grandmother's anointing, like Timothy did, who was anointed by his mother Eunice and by his generations before him. Let it be like Jesus when he arrived, the son of David, a lineage of power. We call forth angelic beings this weekend to rest in that auditorium and to surround us with swords of fire and power in that auditorium. We call for women of worship. We call for women that are going to break through tonight and tomorrow night. And then, Lord, we declare and decree that as we move into our Sunday morning service, that you are going to take the anointing that the women have given birth to, and you're going to bleed it into Sunday morning service, and we're going to see souls saved, delivered, and energized by your power. And so right now, Lord, we just start giving you praise. We just start worshiping you. We just start glorifying you. We just start magnifying you. We just start lifting you up. There is none like you. You are God above all. You are God above everything. And Lord, we pray for every woman watching right now that has a desire to get to Covered Girl. Do it. Step out on faith. Make it happen. Make an investment in your life. You'll never be the same. You'll never be bound like you were. You'll never be depressed leaving this conference. I speak joy. I speak peace. I speak power. I speak deliverance. I speak right now in the name of Jesus, as if you're at the last point of giving birth. I speak a push in your spirit, in the name of Jesus. Somebody clap your hands and give God praise in here. Somebody clap your hands and give God praise in here. Amen.
Father, in Jesus' name, we set our faith in agreement this morning, and we declare, God, that every need, every spiritual need is met. That every woman, Father, that shows up in that building today, we declare God, that they are coming in, Father. God, experiencing the filling, God, of the Holy Spirit. I declare, Father, that every purpose and every assignment, every anointing, that God, that they need to give birth to, that right now, God, that God, their baby is now, God, crowning in Jesus' name. I declare, Father, that this is the season of birthing. I thank you, Father, that the next level is about to go. We're about to move into the next level. I declare, Father, that according to the thing, Father, that not only are you covering, God, your girls, but I declare in Jesus' name that everybody who sets foot, God, on that property on North Hiawassee Road is about to soar in Jesus' name. That we're moving to the next place. We're moving to the next dimension. We're moving to the next arena, Father. We're moving up higher and higher and higher. Father, we call the budget met and exceeded in Jesus' name. We declare that there is no financial lack for Judah, that there is absolutely no hindrance financially. We cancel the curse of debt. We declare in Jesus' name that God, every person that's being moved to sow, that every person, I thank you, Father, that you're raising up people around this world that are being moved to sow into this move of God, that they will become a financial midwife to this move of God in the name of Jesus, God, that you are causing them, God, to be moved, God, to plant a seed into fertile soil. I declare, Father, that hearts are being moved, that God, every person that shows up will see it as more than just meeting the budget, but Father, sowing into the future, Father, sowing into their own future. I thank you that every seed that is deposited, there's a supernatural wind and grace for immediate and accelerated turnaround in the name of Jesus. I speak it, I prophesy it now. I prophesy, Father, accelerated harvest. I prophesy, God, immediate return. I prophesy, God, immediate response in the name of Jesus. Phone calls, text messages, emails of promotion, Father, open doors of opportunity, open doors of favor in the name of Jesus. We cancel, Father, every fear that may rest upon the hearts of your people. Maybe there are people that are walking in, God, tonight that are in financial distress, that are dealing with issues. I pray that this women's conference is more than just, God, an emotional healing moment, but God, as you heal emotions and as you deal with deficits, Father, as you handle, God, the mental breakdowns, oh Father, that women have had to deal with, I pray, Father, that you would bless them financially, that you would increase them according to your word, according to your promise, that God, you would cause them, God, to experience favor and acceleration in their businesses. I call business owners to be birthed out of Covered Girl. I call, God, for greater opportunities to be birthed out of Covered Girl, that people are connecting with their purpose and they're walking in power in the name of Jesus. Say, we serve your notice tonight, today, and we declare, because we made this sacrifice to call on God, to reach out to God, to call on Jesus. We serve you notice today, Satan, that your tricks, your plans, your schemes are not null and void. It has failed, and we speak life, favor, abundance, increase, deliverance, breakthrough, freedom in the name of Jesus. Life, freedom, abundance, breakthrough, deliverance in the name of Jesus. Life, freedom, abundance, breakthrough, increase in the name of Jesus.
Come on, lift your hands. To break every chain, to break every chain. Break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
See, there is power.
There is power in the name of Jesus.
you know, sometimes God will take you back. Sometimes God grabs you and pulls you back. Because I've been in this thing a long time. And years ago, I wrote a book about Elizabeth. How John was not moving in her womb even after 6 months. But the minute Mary stepped in her house, she didn't see Mary, she heard Mary. And faith don't come by what you see. Faith comes by what you hear. And the Bible says Elizabeth was sitting in a different part of the house. And when she heard Mary's voice, the Bible said that thing that was in her spirit began to leap in her womb. And I wrote a book called Make My Baby Jump. And I came to this prayer this morning. And all the way to this building, I began to ask God, God, every woman that registers at this conference and walks through those back doors, from the first sound they hear from that auditorium, I want the thing that you have inside of them to begin to leap with power, leap with expectation, and leap with purpose in the name of Jesus. Ladies, lay your hands on your belly in here as a sign. We're praying for other women right now. Father, I pray right now that just like all the other hundreds of women that are coming, we have today in this room women that are giving birth to a purpose. And Lord, we pray that whatever happens in this conference, that you would make our baby jump this morning. And you would make our baby jump tonight. And you'd make our baby jump tomorrow morning, Saturday night and Sunday. And we declare it to be so in the name of Jesus. And this baby that Elizabeth gave birth to was not just an average child. This baby came out with a purpose to declare who Jesus was. And so I declare that from this weekend forward, everything that comes out of your life is going to shout, there is the Lamb that take away the sins of the world. And I'm believing for a breakthrough for every woman in the name of Jesus to happen this weekend at Covered Girl. Do I have any Covered Girls in here this morning praying? Pastor Jane Hall, come. Come, let's close this thing with a woman giving God prayer.
Glory to God. God, we give you glory and honor this morning. We are the body of Christ, and we're praying for the body of Christ this morning. God, I thank you for our pastor's wife, Pastor Kendall Brown, this morning. God, we lift her up before you in the mighty name of Jesus. God, we cover her in the blood of Jesus today. God, I decree the armor of God is upon her today. God, you are the God of the armor, protecting her and watching over her, God. I decree the fruits of the Spirit are in her right now, God, manifesting in her right now. God, as she's coming forth and she's giving birth, God, God, let your presence be upon her today. God, let the Spirit of the Lord be upon her today in the mighty name of Jesus. God, speak a new word to her tonight in the name of Jesus, God. Bless her as she comes and as she goes. God, guide her steps, God. Direct her path, God, as only you can, God. God, we cover her in the precious blood of Jesus tonight. God, we cover her. God, as the women walk through the doors tonight, God, we speak a word over your women tonight. God, we pray for the helpless and the hopeless, God. Yes. We pray for the single woman tonight, God. Yes. We pray for the struggling mom tonight. We pray for the unemployed. We pray for the underemployed, God. We lift up your people as never before, God. God, we decree you are God who can do it, God. God, your word says I am. God, we decree you are the I am today. You are the I am in whatever the situation is. You are the I am our healer. You are the I am our deliverer today. You are the I am the manifest of all things, oh God. God, we give you glory this morning. We give you praise, God. We bless your name, God, today. We bless your name today. Precious Holy Spirit, I thank you, God. I thank you, God. Spirit of the living God, you fall fresh on us tonight. Fall fresh on us tonight. Spirit of the living God, open doors tonight, oh God. God, I thank you for salvation. I thank you for healing, God. I thank you for deliverances that never before, God. I thank you, God, for a new thing. God, I thank you. This is the beginning of a new thing in us, in the mighty name of Jesus. And we lift it up before you this morning. We lift it up before you. God, again, we cover in the name of Jesus. And we thank you for it. Hallelujah, God.
There is power. Name of Jesus. Come on, ladies. There is. time. There